Hey everyone, I'm just in the field here. We've been cutting today. As you can see over here, I just finished this top field. I got this one and the front one to go. I worked on all yesterday to kind of get going and just make sure everything's going. And this is where we're at. I'll take you guys along. So, sorry about the bouncing, but that's just gonna be part of it. Trying not to mess too much with you guys, but there's no straight edges on this farm. So you kind of get what you can get. And my action camera likes dying really quickly. So every time I think I'm gonna film some stuff with that, it just doesn't happen. And then we end up here. But I know this is me being young and kind of learning and stuff, but I've kind of learned really quickly that you don't rush things. I find the more I rush things, the more stuff breaks. So yesterday I went nice and slow and just went through everything, not in a rush, knowing that maybe I would be able to cut today, and that's what we're kind of working on. But I really want to emphasize this because this is the stuff everyone wants to see. The nice action shots of the tractor jockeys where you jump in and just start mowing hay and the equipment's ready to go. It's all fueled up and everything's oiled and greased and you just gotta drive it. This is only a small piece of this experience, and I don't feel that everyone shows the other piece. You don't see me working on the equipment. You don't see me having a $5,000 bill saying how I'm gonna pay for this, or you don't see people going, I don't know where I'm gonna come up with $7,000 after having losses. You don't see that, and I just want to make sure that you guys know that this is the fun part. This is what everyone likes seeing. This is the part where it's an experience for all that work and effort. This is what it all adds up to, is you get equipment that works well in the fields, and you don't have to worry as much about as much breakdowns. You still see breakdowns, but you don't see them as much. And you can be efficient and you can be effective with your time. And so this is that exciting part. So the cow's still down. I'm gonna have to try and lift her up. For any of you guys that have watched my last video, I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet. I've thought about straps. I've also thought about a C-clamp that goes on their hips so you can lift them from their hips. I'm gonna look into that and see if some of the dairy guys around me would have one. So you can just attach it to the loader and do that. She seems in pretty good spirits, but I wanna see if I can get her up and get her going. So that's what I'm gonna do after I get cut and raked. I might put the loader on and see what we can do on that, because I'd like to get that going. And that's what's going on, guys. I know this looks bumpy, but you should have seen the rest of the fields. That's why I film in certain locations. You're gonna notice that with me, is you're gonna see a lot of the same location, because at the end of the day, there's certain parts of the field that are crazy bumpy because it hasn't been plowed and it's clay. So what happens is you get huge bumps and then they stay and then it hardens and you hit that with the tractor. That's why you don't see me pushing the equipment too hard, because it's not worth breaking a mower bar over. It's not worth smashing up a tractor over, because it's just, the equipment's too expensive. So that's what's going on, guys. Take care.
Actually, I finished without being dark, so I figured I'd give you guys a quick rundown here. I just finished. I got all of our farm done. So this one is split into halves. So it's roughly 50 acres. I think it's like 45 or something like that. But got her all done. It's all down. It's drying pretty good. It's low humidity today, so next couple days are supposed to be this way. The timothy was just starting to come up as this hay got put down, so who knows if it comes back for second cut. But it's not super thick, not as thick as I'd like, but on the other hand too, I can't really expect huge things because I didn't lay fertilizer down like I should have. And like I talked to you guys before, this is what happens, is you can already see little cracks. You get, the moisture dries out of the clay and it turns to concrete. And I want to change that with some aeration and in the future hopefully improve that and get better yields. But this year, this is where it stands. So hopefully I have enough for my own cattle and sell some on the side and make some money. Actually, here we go. So yeah, there is Timothy in it. But I just wanted to show you guys this before it got too dark. So thanks again for watching.